Welcome back. In this video, we will go over the anatomy of the thigh bone, the femur. This is a femur. It's a long bone in shape. It has two ends and a shaft. The femur is the largest bone in the body. Notice how it carries the entire body weight. The femur articulates with the pelvic bone medially, and this is the proximal part of the femur. This forms the hip joint. The femur articulates distally with the kneecap, the patella, the tibia, and the fibula at the knee joint right here. Before we start with the structures of the femur, let's first identify the four surfaces of the femur when the bone is in the anatomical position. First, this right here, the head. The head always faces medially so that it can articulate with the pelvic bone. So this is the medial aspect. Right here, this is the lateral aspect. This right here is the anterior aspect. Notice how the anterior aspect is smooth. Whereas notice how the posterior aspect has different structures on it. Starting with the first structure, this right here is the head. As we said, the head faces medially so that it articulates with the hip bone. This forms the hip joint. On the head, we can see a small depression right here. This is the fovea capitis for a ligament attachment. Fovea capitis. Capitis means head. Fovea, a small depression. Moving to the neck. This is the neck of the femur. Moving to the two trochanters. This right here is a trochanter and this is a trochanter. How will you differentiate between them? This is the lesser trochanter and this is the greater trochanter. On the anterior aspect, we can see right here the intertrochanteric line, which is a smooth line. Inter means between. Trochanteric line. Whereas on the posterior aspect, notice the difference, we have the intertrochanteric crest. So this is a line and this is a crest. Moving to the shaft, the anterior aspect of the shaft is smooth, whereas on the posterior aspect, we can see this rough edge right here. This is the linea aspera. So this sharp border is the linea aspera. Moving to the distal part of the femur, let's first start with the anterior surface. Right here, this is the patellar surface. Notice how smooth it is for the patella to articulate with the femur. So that is the patellar surface right here. Moving to the two epicondyles. This tip right here is an epicondyle. This is an epicondyle as well. Both are epicondyles. How will you differentiate between them? The head will guide you toward the medial epicondyle because the head faces medially. So this right here is the medial epicondyle. The opposite one is the lateral epicondyle. Above the medial epicondyle, we have the adductor tubercle right here. So this is the adductor tubercle and this is the medial epicondyle. Let's move to the posterior aspect of the distal part of the femur. On the posterior aspect, we have these two condyles. So this surface is a condyle and this is a condyle. How will you differentiate between them? This right here, which is facing toward the head of the femur, this is the medial condyle and this is the lateral condyle. In between them, we have the intercondylar fossa, also called the intercondylar notch. So let's repeat the structures one more time. This is the head of the femur. On the head of the femur, we can see the fovea capitis. This right here is the neck of the femur. This is the lesser trochanter. This is the greater trochanter. Anteriorly, we have the intertrochanteric line. Posteriorly, we have the intertrochanteric crest. crest. This is the shaft. On the shaft, posteriorly, we have the linea aspera. Moving to the distal part, this right here is the patellar surface. This is the medial epicondyle. Above it, we have the adductor tubercle. On the opposite side, we have the lateral epicondyle. Moving to the posterior aspect, this right here is the medial condyle. This is the lateral condyle. In between them, we have the intercondylar fossa, also called the intercondylar notch. Let's answer the question, is that the right or the left femur? To answer it correctly, you need to imagine the bone in its anatomical position and to identify the four surfaces based on that. The answer is, this is the left femur. I hope you found the video helpful. Hit the like button and subscribe for more amazing content.